All right, so we've just told you about the Uber hack, the company now coming out a year later saying they covered it up, paid them off. What's this going to do for Uber in general as a company? Let's bring in Mike Eppel now. And, you know, they were set to share for their shares for their company going public there. So now what's next for them?
That's the big question now, isn't it, Melanie? Next year, we were expecting maybe an Uber initial public stock sale. And does this delay that? Probably not, because Uber had already replaced its CEO with new leadership earlier this year. And the chief security officer, Joe Sullivan, has been fired in the wake of this story about them covering up this data breach and paying the hackers to actually destroy the data. So it's not necessarily about the crime, it's about the cover-up and whether or not they have the management in place to take this company to the next level. In so many cases, you know, it's just because you can design and build a tech company, or any company for that matter, you might not have the managerial skills to, again, see it grow, and Uber has grown exponentially since its inception not that long ago. So expect an Uber stock sale likely next year, if the market conditions are right, of course, because the demand will certainly be there, because Uber is worth billions of dollars. Price for oil coming into the U.S. Thanksgiving break at a 2.5-year high as of this morning, almost $58 per barrel for West Texas crude, the benchmark. Price out of the U.S. getting a lift because of the Keystone XL pipeline shutdown due to that oil leak in South Dakota, which TransCanada Corp is still trying to fix. And as well, 46 to 50 million American vehicles. Americans will be hitting the roads this weekend for U.S. Thanksgiving, not even including train and rail travel. Our train and plane travel. So busy time on the roads. And again, global economic growth also lifting the price for oil. Probably lead to an increase in the pumps that we'll see over the next few days. Wall Street stocks, big day yesterday. 160-point gain for the Dow. NASDAQ's at a record. All of the benchmarks on Wall Street at the records. So Americans going into the U.S. Thanksgiving break tomorrow probably going to be spending more over the U.S. retail sales season, Black Friday coming up. And that is going to be very important. Consider the fact that companies like Sears Holdings in the United States, Sears here in Canada, of course, in liquidation. Sears Holdings, this could be a make-or-break Christmas sales season for that company. So that's something to watch with Americans set to hit the malls big time, probably actually already on Thursday afternoon. And Melanie, as Americans are driving to their various destinations and the highways are crowded stateside, an estimated 50 million cars extra on the road and 50 million turkeys set to be devoured over the Thanksgiving break as well. Lots of spending in the United States.
So oh, yeah.
The studio.
And on this side of the border, too, right?
Yeah,
Black
yeah.
Friday, where a lot of people are heading online. And even just in the stores here, they're already started, the sales.
That's and the other thing, too, keep in mind, we're expecting a pretty good activity here for sales because the economy is doing pretty well.
It's true. Very true. All right. Happy shopping, Mike.
Thank you.